Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
The Speaking Podcast is brought to you by our friends at Flemington Car and Truck Country. Best car buying experience ever online at Flemington.com. Award-winning House of Cupcakes, HouseofCupcakes.com, and Casa Gennaro's. Reservations, call 609-683-1212.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Speaking Quarantine Podcast. I'm Jay Black, joined by Jessica Gibson. Hello, Jessica.
Hello. Thanks for having me. Oh, my gosh. So great to be here.
Yeah, it feels like only about 8 hours ago that we just recorded last week's, and here we are 168 hours later, recording another one. And, Jessica, we had a 5 minute conversation before the podcast, and she said, "Why aren't we recording this?" Which was, the right answer. Now, Jessica, having heard the plot of the movie, should I have let my daughter watch this movie?
Having heard your wife's voice explaining what was happening over your explanation, I think, like, totally clued me off that she should not have been watching this.
Yeah.
And yet you remind me of my cool uncle that used to play South Park when I was in, like, sixth grade.
Yeah.
And just explain those jokes, which, you know, by the time I was in college, I started to understand what they were talking about.
Right. It's probably good to be a cool uncle, but you shouldn't be a cool uncle when you're the father. So I feel kind of bad. I just, so the people at home know, I let my daughter watch, you know, probably about 45 minutes of Stanley Kubrick's Lolita, which, if you don't know, is a movie about a pervert named Humbert, actually, is his name. I always do the French pronunciation. Who marries a woman, falls in love with the woman's daughter. They run off together after the woman kills herself, here, like, realizing that her husband is a weirdo with his with her 15-year-old daughter. By the way, in the book, she was 12. In the movie, they upped her age to 15 to make it, I guess, less awful. I mean, it, both of it's awful.
Make it more relatable.
Yeah, exactly. My daughter and I watched it mostly for Peter Sellers, who is plays Claire Quilty, the sort of dark image to Humbert. Because my daughter wants to be a comedic actress, so we were watching Peter Sellers and how great Peter Sellers is in that movie. But we had to wait till my wife left so I wouldn't get in trouble for showing it to her. But I sit with her, Jessica, and explain.
She wasn't at the store long enough to get through the whole movie, it sounds like.
No, she came home and I got in trouble. But here's why I justify it. Because it's important for a 9-year-old girl like my daughter to understand that all men are evil and awful and to stay away from them.
Oh, man.
All men, Jessica.
That's not true. What about her brothers?
Yeah, no, her brothers are awful too. I mean, not awful in the same way that, like, a guy not in her family is awful, but still awful. Just stay away from all boys at all times, always. You know why fathers want girls to stay away from boys? I'll tell you, Jessica.
Why?
Because we're all liars who are waiting for a girl to figure out that we're liars. And when we get one, we go, oh, my God, she fell for it. And then we marry her. And then, like, years go by, and then you have a daughter, and you realize, oh, my God, there's going to be other men coming to lie to this girl as well. And you know all their tricks. So you're like, oh, God, no, don't fall for the same thing your mother fell for. That's why. Because we know how awful men are. And when we see you credulous, like, you're like, oh, no, there's some good guys. No,
yeah.
There's no good guys, Jessica.
Oh,
they're,
man,
all terrible. Now,
I feel like you're missing the biggest part of this is when we got on the phone before we recorded. You're like, oh, I'm so casually just watching the classics.
Yeah.
We had to finish the classic movie with my daughter. And I was like, I have a feeling it's not Lion King.
Yeah. Oh, no. I got YouTube TV, which is, like, we talked about this. This an AMC has all of their movies commercial free. So I just went through and did like 100 classic movies and like movies from the 20s, 30s, and 40s, that I, and in this case, the 60s, that I've been wanting to watch. So the quarantine, I've been going through them. And my daughter is the only one who cares enough about old movies to come in and watch with me.
Yeah, Chase would not sit down and watch me that with me for sure.
Oh, he's not a big black and white 2-hour and 40-minute 1960 kind of movie guy?
No, but I like some of them are so ridiculous, like How to Marry a Millionaire.
Oh, is that Jane Mansfield in that?
Yeah, I think that was on like Netflix. So like I saw that, you know, before the quarantine, but those are good movies.
I love them. I love them so much.
Casablanca.
Casablanca, I saw in the theater at a revival with my son. Now, I've seen the movie like 10,000 times, but when you see it in the theater and it was a sold out screening, you realize that every single thing Humphrey Bogart says in that movie is hilarious because like you can't stop laughing. I think all men, I've wanted to write a book about this for the longest time, which is Humphrey Bogart's like 5'5", 130 pounds. He's got a gross, ugly troll face. And yet every single guy who's ever seen a Humphrey Bogart movie wants to be Humphrey Bogart. And I want to get to the root of why that is, because I think it explains men.
Oh, interesting. Maybe because I can't see how tall he is.
Possibly because he's so short, but I think there's something about the fact that he's completely disconnected emotionally from everything around him that all men go, yeah, that seems nice. I'd like to be disconnected emotionally as well.
Yeah. But no, I can see that. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like every time an emotion actually squeaks through my head, I'm like, oh no, this sucks. There's never been something good that's coming out of me having an emotion.
Yeah. I thought you were emotional since you're always like talking.
So here's the thing. That's why I admire Humphrey Bogart. Yeah, I am, yes, very much an emotional person, but I'm still a man. So I hate all of it. You know what I mean? Like as the emotions are coming out of me, like I have very high highs, very low lows. I hug and kiss the people that I love constantly. But every time it happens, I'm like, I should probably not be doing any of this. I should probably be in a room smoking cigarettes and drinking scotch and not showing anybody any kind of feeling at all.
Yeah, like a gangster.
Like Humphrey Bogart. But just getting back to that just original thought about all men being evil, I realized something watching my wife, which is my wife knows that all girls are evil too. Because when she sees, like, I was like, you know, I know that you tricked me. Like I could see my daughters do it where they go, Daddy, I need your muscles. And I jump out and go, how can I help? I need to show you that I'm strong. But they, like, my daughter's 4 and manipulating me in order to get me to do stuff that she wants me to do by complimenting my ego. And I'm like, what are you going to do when, like, there's a girl in Keen's life doing that to him, like, manipulating him? And she's like, I'll kill that bitch.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
I don't have brothers, but I always hear, like, that's what, like, sisters worry about is, like, some girl just swinging in, and all of a sudden, your brother just listens to him all the time.
Just gets sucked in the same way you want to control them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm convinced that's the popularity of The Sims. Like women love that video game, The Sims, I think because they can just make them do whatever. It's like a dollhouse where everybody has to do exactly what they say.
Right. Have you been sucked into The Sims during quarantine?
So we haven't been playing The Sims. We've been playing, I think we talked about this before, Jackbox TV, which I cannot recommend highly enough. But my son and daughter just started playing Civilization with me. And I told you about this one too. You start as a settler, and then it takes like 10 hours to play one game, and you like create a vast, powerful empire. And it's wonderful that my kids are playing now.
Oh man, so nothing's changed in the past week.
Well, the one thing that has changed, Jessica, is my bike finally got fixed. So all 5 of us can go out and ride our bikes together. And we're like now I realized just as it was about to come out of me, it's going to sound racist, but it's my last name, so it's not. We're like a black biker gang.
Oh, that sounded so sweet until you put it that way.
Yeah. So you're just like riding around, just like finding punks that we can we do our bike circle around. It's awesome.
They just reopened all the trails around me and like my dog park and stuff, so I can now ride around on there guilt free.
Wait, is
I used
this
to just sneak on and feel really entitled and jerky about it?
Are you happy about this, though? Because aren't people coming to the trails, like, from outside of your town, or no?
Yeah, well, people will have to, like, a lot of people will drive over, but I just felt really guilty, like, being on there in the first place when it clearly had, like, red stop signs saying, trails closed, turn back, it's not accessible, so which obviously it's a trail in the woods, so you can obviously get to it anytime.
You were doing it anyway, so what you're saying is you were, but now you don't have to feel bad about it.
Well, because it was like right in my backyard. I wasn't like parking and taking a trip to get there.
Right. Yeah, you feel kind of ownership of that.
Yeah, I mean, and there's nowhere else to go.
Jessica, I'm very curious. What do you think about all these states that are like, because we're recording this Tuesday afternoon. It'll publish tomorrow. So we're up to date here. We're not recording this months ago. The protest happened this weekend where people were going out to reopen the government during the pandemic. I think you can guess how I feel about this. But I'm curious, what do you feel about this?
Some of the people walking around the streets of the capitals with guns.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, those are creeps. Don't, like, put me in that bucket. Right. I think that we saved a lot of lives quarantining and helping the population that, you know, would have really gotten, we would have lost a lot of people.
Right.
But, yeah, I think we do need to open back up because I can't imagine being laid off or furloughed and not sure how you're going to pay your bills. So you don't want, you know, all the fixes to be worse than what's happening.
So what if the experts are correct? And I tend to think that they are. If we open up early, everything relapses, it goes terribly again, and then we have to start from square one. If that happens, like, if the choices are wait 2 more weeks and be okay, or open up immediately and possibly have to do this for another 2 months, like, it doesn't playing safe make sense here?
Well, I think my walking trails and stuff were closed like 2 weeks later. So if they're opening up 2 weeks earlier, I feel like that's kind of on the path that people are recommending.
Here's what I'll say. I am 100% okay with Republicans going back to work. So I'm clear with that. I say go for it. And then we'll hang out. The rest of us will hang out in quarantine. And we'll see. We'll just see how it shakes out.
It feels like it's an evil streak that you're...
No. I think that this will truly make America great again. But here's the thing. If you are somebody that is protesting that you want to go back to work, you have to sign away your rights to go to the hospital. Everybody else gets to go to the hospital in front of you. And I think if we do that, then we're clear. Because then you want to take
along the ventilator.
Right. The ventilator goes to somebody who, you know, because I have friends right now who one just got out of the ICU. He's a doctor. And his wife is now in the ICU. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you're just like outside looking in.
Oh, my God. That's so sad.
It's terrible. And it's like, yeah, this is people are dying. You know?
Yeah. But like when this started, like, you know, stay inside, quarantine. But like I see my parents a lot. And I think they'd be really upset if I was just kind of MIA for a whole month, not like showing up for any family events. So I didn't want to like upset them more by like avoiding them all this time versus staying in my house. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want things to be worse off after the fact because we did what the government went and told us to do. And you don't want to overreact.
So there's a great thing called the overreaction paradox. And I think that's what we're doing right now, which is everything seems like an overreaction when it works.
Mm-hmm.
So like if you go, oh my God, that spark is going to burn down the house and you throw a bucket of water on it. That seems like an overreaction. But everything seems like an overreaction if your house doesn't burn down. So, like, the longer your house doesn't burn down, it seems like everything that you're doing to prevent your house from burning down is an overreaction. But something that's in, like, looks like an overreaction could quite possibly be just the appropriate reaction because it's working. And having, like, both of my parents dead, I'll tell you, I'd rather my parents be alive and mad at me than dead and not.
Yeah, but my parents are, like, your age.
Yeah, that's true. I am very old. I lost my mom when I was your age. And I lost my dad, was it 7 years ago now? God dang, I'm old. My father-in-law was like doing the thing where he was like driving around and like he'd like every boomer figuring like, well, I'm invincible. And I showed him, I sent him a video of what the ICU looks like right now that was making its way around the internet. And yeah. I explained to him, like, yeah, no, this is going to, like, murder you, and you can be as mad as you want at me, but, like, hey, in a year when you're able to yell at me for being an overreactive liberal cuck, that would be great. I would be thrilled for you to be able to do that rather than be dead.
So is that, this is a fight you guys did have?
It is a fight that, it was a one-sided fight because he, like, there was no leg for him to stand on. He was like, well... No, I mean, it's not that bad. I'm like, no, you're not coming into my house. If you want to like talk to us through the door to see your grandkids, you can. And like early on, he thought I was being ridiculous. And all of my relatives think I'm being ridiculous. But as this thing has drawn on, they've gone, well, maybe Jay had a point. As, 50,000 people are dead now.
Yeah. No, that's sad.
Yeah. So, I don't want to turn this into just a conversation about coronavirus because I'm sure everybody everywhere is having it. But like, mm-hmm. I do believe when it comes to like weird alien pandemics that no one understands, better safe than sorry. Because you're saying now there are people that like had it that are getting it again, which seems insane.
Yeah.
So like, just stay away. Everybody stay home.
I mean, I don't know what side of the argument I'm on. Like, I do think people need to make money and like have some type of income before they get very hurt. Yeah. But I haven't left my house like much at all.
Other than
to see my parents.
I'll be honest with you. The Bernie Sanders $2,000 a month to every person in the country until this thing is over sounds great to me.
Mm-hmm. I'm not getting that though.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you're already making money, you're good. But like, you know, and I'll be honest, I've been doing pretty well with these college shows, so I'm doing just fine. So I think that everybody that needs it, just take care of them. Like, if your uncle had tuberculosis and was coughing up blood and was like, I got to go work in the coal mine, you'd go, hey, Uncle Joe, don't work in the coal mine. You're going to die. I will take care of you to the best of my ability. I think we just need to do that. As a country, for everyone.
Just like, I think that's why Bill is not getting on these podcasts. He doesn't want to have this conversation with you.
Well, it's one of those deals where, like, all of this makes a lot more sense in the face of a pandemic. Like, when you're talking about, like, should we take care of someone who lost their job in a regular time, maybe it's a little bit easier to take the conservative approach. But I think, like, if you can't work, like Republican governors getting up there and going like, well, we got to open the economy. What are you going to do? It's like, not open the economy. Like that's what
you, yeah. Like, but I could see like from your dad just being like, you know, what is he in his 80s? Just being like, I'm living my life. No one's going to tell me what to do, especially not the government. Like you can see that angle too, right? Like why he feels that way.
I can understand why he feels that way, but the fact that he endangers everybody else is the problem. If he wants to not wear a seatbelt, fine. Then just die when you hit a car. But this is not the equivalent of the government telling you what to do. This is the equivalent of the government telling you don't drink and drive. Like, it's not overwhelming to, it's not an overreach for the government to go, if you get into a car when you're drunk, you've done something wrong. You can spread disease to other people by doing this. So if you're just walking around doing whatever the hell you want to do because the government isn't going to tell you what to do and you get a health worker sick or you get a family member sick or if you get some jerk, some like poor jerk working at a supermarket sick, then you're evil. You're not just being like, the government can't tell me what to do. I'm a libertarian. You're murdering people. So don't do that.
Last time I was at the grocery store, there was a woman with, she was way older. So I was already like, you know, why is she in the middle of the day or, you know, at the end of the day, like not going during senior hour shopping.
Right.
She had this like 6 foot pole with her. And I was like, is she going to whack me with that?
I love that.
It's like, am I going to get hit if this lady gets too close to me going down the aisle?
I told my son that I'm going to start wearing clown pants. You know, there's like clown, like the ones that have a hoop on it. You know, like the big giant clown. I'm going to get 6 foot clown pants so that no one can get within 6 feet of me.
Where do you get them from?
I'm assuming a clown emporium.
Oh, okay. Clown school.
Clown school. Perhaps Amazon.clown. It's Amazon for clowns.
I was walking down the trail and there was this like very Euro guy, like dressed, walking down in the opposite direction, smile waved at me. He had so much cologne on when we passed each other. It was definitely like more than 6 feet away. And I was like, that's a method of keeping people away. Just to completely drown yourself in like Gucci cologne.
You know what? Maybe he's protecting himself. Like maybe the coronavirus can't survive like Drakkar Noor. What's it?
Like all of that alcohol in it.
Yeah. Like somebody sneezes on him, but the coronavirus is going to die 2 feet out from the Gucci cologne.
Yeah.
Obsession by Calvin Klein is the only thing known to take out COVID-19.
Exactly.
Yeah. I guess because I'm still doing okay doing comedy shows and I'm enjoying my quarantine watching inappropriate movies with my daughter, I'd like it to go on. I'm just thinking another 35 years.
Have you left the house at all?
I haven't left the house in 3 weeks.
I'm just imagining your daughter, like 35, at her virtual like laptop wedding, but she's just going to live in your house, and then
I am 100% okay with this.
Be married off on Facebook Live.
That's fine. She can get married in Second Life. I'm fine with that. She can have like some avatar do the marriage thing. That's fine by me.
Right.
And there's still lots of movies that we haven't watched together. So I just want to stay in my, I've left my house to take walks, but I haven't gone to a store. I haven't been in a car in 3 weeks. It's weird. I feel like I'm a European peasant.
Yeah. You're not going to be able to drive anymore.
Yeah. But I fixed a dishwasher. I told you, I cleaned my whole garage and I'm thinking about building a deck.
Oh, that'd be awesome. You got to build a deck.
So I got to get a circular saw, and I got to get wood and a nail gun. And I don't...
And like a friend who knows what he's doing.
So I figure I can figure it out myself.
YouTube, baby.
YouTube and time. If you YouTube plus time equals anything.
Well, it sounds like you're being very productive.
I love it. This is great. All I needed was the government to tell me not to leave my house for 3 weeks, and I'm finally getting shit done.
Yeah, I haven't gotten bored, like, yet, because I haven't run out of all my errands on my to-do list, like gardening and that type of thing.
I read an article that was interesting about how, like, a forced pause. We've never had a forced pause like this before, where the whole country's had to, like, just sort of take a breather all at once. Like, Americans don't take vacations. Like, we don't
Europeans take vacations.
Yeah, where the European will go on holiday for a month. Like, that's anathema to an American. But we've had to do it for the last month. And I'm wondering what it's going to be when we come back. Like, you know, just the reorganization of, like, yeah, you know what? Maybe I don't need 16 hours a day of all the shit that I was doing. Maybe I only need, like, 4 hours a day of that because I like gardening.
Right.
And I think that could be good from a, like, social perspective of all of us just sort of slowing down. Like, did you know the Russians have an idiom, work like an American?
No. Like, because they're probably tired of the Russians coming here to, like, pursue whatever job they wanted to do.
Well, yeah, it's like, we have busy as a beaver. They have, I'm working like an American.
Because, no, I didn't know that.
Yeah, I mean, Americans, like, it's funny, we're always castigating ourselves for being lazy, but on the other hand, we work 12 hours a day, and, like, we don't even go to lunch. We just, like, go through a drive-thru and have people throw Taco Bell in our mouth at 50 miles an hour so we can get back to work faster. I mean, we work a lot.
Yeah, I mean, I feel good when I'm busy, though, so I feel like that's why I do it, right?
Right, but there's busy, and there's also, like, I'm gardening. I'm doing to-do stuff
like,
around my house.
I'm going to build a deck. Like, that is busy. That is work. That's not, like, having a super long lunch.
Yeah, I guess what it is it's busy, but it's busy in the pursuit of something different than just work for work's sake. I'm not doing profit. Well, I'm in a weird position because I do what I love, and I don't think a lot of people get to do that. Like, everything I get to do is, like, fun for me. But, like, I could imagine working a job you don't like to earn money to hire somebody else to build a deck for you. Like, there's something a little bit more noble, not noble, but more satisfying in going, well, I have the time. Maybe I'll just build a deck. And I'm not just talking about me. I'm talking about, like, everybody at once in America is doing that. Like, everywhere I walk, people are doing, like, gardening and building stuff and, like, washing their car and just enjoying life. It's like America's on a perpetual Sunday afternoon, and I'm kind of digging it.
Okay, but, like, in March, this all happened, like, the weekend after my birthday weekend, so not to brag,
Jessica.
But I had the great birthday party, and then the following, like, Wednesday, everything shut down, and then it led into, like, St. Patrick's Day and stuff, so I had, like, a bunch of, like, free weekends already that, like, this really didn't, like, disrupt any plans, but now it's getting into, like, people canceling weddings and, like, major prom, graduation, life events that are being canceled. That's when it's, like, getting sad.
That's not great. No, that's not.
Yeah.
But, like, all those times that you went out to brunch just to go out to brunch.
Yeah. Skipped all those.
Those are, I'm not missing that at all. Like, I'm not missing leaving the house to go do stuff just to have something to do. I'm realizing that there's a ton of stuff around the house that just needs my attention. You know, but yeah, I feel bad because my next door neighbor, who I like the kid a lot, he's a senior this year, and he's like all of the senior events like prom and graduation are out the door.
And, yeah, and hopefully he didn't play baseball. Like, that would suck.
He does. He plays baseball.
Yeah, so poor kid.
It's rough for him. All of this is rough.
Yeah.
But, like, That's why, Jessica, we got to keep the country closed down for another month. I say.
Because why?
To stamp it all out.
Okay.
Honestly, if no one left the house for a month and all the people who had it just, you know, either died or got better, it would go away forever.
I keep thinking about what that psychic said from the very beginning, like 20 years ago. Do you remember that?
No. What did the psychic say?
Some psychic in this book, she was like a famous psychic, wrote down, like, in the spring of 2020, a crazy virus will come out of nowhere and, like, infect the whole earth. And then it'll go down and it'll spring up again a little bit in the fall, and then it'll never come back again.
That's, first off, a stopped clock is right twice a day. So every once in a while, the sun shines on a dog's butt.
Yeah.
So if you make 1,000 guesses, you'll get it. But yeah, that's how viruses work. Like, to me, us staying inside for another month is the equivalent of, like, you know how they shut down, like, one lane of a road to try to keep the road open, but all they wind up doing is, like, taking the project, like, make it 2-week project into 5-month project, and traffic is terrible the whole time. So they just shut the whole road down for 2 weeks. This is the equivalent of that.
Or just wait until the quarantine and do all the road projects then.
Oh, my God, that's such a good idea.
Yeah.
All right, on that note, Jessica...
Okay.
Do you have anything else? Wait, real fast.
No, it was good talking to you.
Was it, though? It's always good talking to you. But every once in a while, I go, like, yeah, people probably shouldn't talk to me. How's Chase's beard gone?
Chase's beard is gone, and he finally got a haircut for the first time in a month.
Nice. Did you cut his hair, or did he go somewhere?
Actually, his mom cut his hair.
Oh, good for her.
But yeah, he looks so much better.
What about the video games?
It was weird to, like, get used to a person walking around all scraggly and then have, like, a beard and stuff, and then suddenly look, like, so much more handsome.
Yeah, he went from hippie to hot.
Right. Yeah.
What about the video games? Is he still playing video games?
Yeah, he's probably in the basement right now playing video games.
Wow. Are you upset with that, or are you going to go down and play with him?
I can't get into the fake football. And then I don't want to buy a game for myself because that's dumb.
No, get a game. Get Animal Crossing.
Get Spider-Man.
Ooh, do you have a PlayStation?
Yeah.
Oh my God, get Spider-Man. It's so good.
Is it really?
Oh, it's the best. You feel like you're Spider-Man. Get Spider-Man. Do it, Jessica.
All right, I guess I might.
Get it? No, you know what? Get it and talk about it on the podcast, and it's a write-off.
All right, sounds good. I'll bill it to Bill.
Yeah, bill and play the, and we'll chat about it next week on Quarantine Live or whatever the hell this is.
All right, sounds good.
All right, Jessica, thanks.
Bye, thank you.
The Speaking Podcast brought to you by our friends at House of Cupcakes, serving you in Princeton, East Brunswick, Clifton, and Saudi Arabia. The winner of Cupcake Wars offers 35 different flavors, perfect for a special occasion or just a sweet treat. Houseofcupcakes.com. The Speaking Podcast is brought to you by our friends at Flemington Car and Truck Country, 16 brands of cars and trucks. I'm a loyal customer buying my last two trucks there and can tell you no one beats the deals or offers better service. Visit Flemington.com. The Speaking Podcast brought to you by our friends at Casa Gennaro's on Route 27 in Kingston. Call 609-683-1212 for reservations. They're open for dinner every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Ask for my favorite special, the Veal Spadia. Best Italian food in Jersey.
Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.